evidence in your delivery of judgment.
The yet-to-be-instituted Supreme Court will have 5 judges who will join the Chief Justice and his deputy in dealing with matters of constitutional law, as well as delivering judgments on election petitions. And as such, Justices Phillip Tunoi, Apondi, Muga and Mohammed Ibrahim were queried over judgments and rulings they have made in the past.
When you look at that background of yours, and you just boast with your judgments, am I wrong to think that it has ingrained in your thinking or your psyche, you know, a sort of anti-government syndrome?
I believe in government. That's why I want to be part in one arm of the government. I want to sustain their institutions.
Share with us how you have demonstrated honesty.
I have never been engaged in any kind of practice which is contrary to my oath of office.
Talk of the importance of separation of powers and judicial independence was also given prominence.
But it's a matter of commitment, and it's a calling. If you have decided that you are going to perform, if you have decided you're going to give service to a particular area of this government, commitment is very important.
Thursday will see former nominated Member of Parliament Joaquin Dungu, Lady Justice Ruth Sitati and Wilfred Nderitu face the panel.
Now, even as the interviews for the Supreme Court judges' positions continue, it is now becoming apparent some of the issues that they will have to face once they begin to serve in the yet-to-be-instituted Supreme Court. Among them are the backlog of cases and ridding the judiciary of the notion from the public that it is corrupt and that impunity exists within its corridors. Willis Raburu, Citizen Live at 9, Nairobi.